and all our tears have reached the sea. Part of you will live in me, way down deep inside my heart. The days keep coming without fail, new wind is gonna find your sail. That's where your journey starts.
I'm trying to put the stakes in the ground, but it's a quite a good feeling to see all this. I mean, it's really remarkable. And beside the people who put their efforts into it, it's just amazing. I mean, you had people out here 83, 84 years old, pounding stakes. It's amazing. It really is. A lot of people gave their lives for what we have here today. So just very thankful for it, to be an American.
Keep these memories alive so that, you know, maybe our young people understand where we've been, so they won't have to repeat the same things. And that's one of the, you know, the greatest gifts we can give our young people is tell where we've been, how we got here, and what the price was that we paid to get here. So in conclusion, just people come out and see this. This is an awesome sight. Just awesome.
Alexis Cook, Abby Broering, Hannah Ainsworth, Gabby Cross, Julie Valentine,
Kyle Segrist,
Anna Mollenkamp,
Ravi Patel,
Cora Weaver,
Alex Dunn,
Hannah Pfeiffer,
Raceland Rice,
Brockton Miller,
Trent Whiteneck,
Tyler Beck,
Ben Engelgarn.
It's been another great holiday this homecoming week as we celebrate the sophomore class with St. Patrick's Day. Watch out for the revelers tomorrow as the juniors and the rest of the students celebrate New Year's Eve. Merry Christmas on Thursday to the seniors. Ho, 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 homecoming. And Friday will be the 4th of July.
Today also marks the 11th anniversary of 9/11. Even though we were very young when the attack on America happened, we should always mark this day and remember the sacrifices and heroism of the many people who were affected by these tragedies. We'll be saying a little more about that, but first let's send it over to sports.
Thanks, ladies. In JC Sports last night, the JV football team lost to Winchester 6-0 in overtime. And freshman team also lost to Southern Wells County with a close score of 13-6.
More JC Sports last night was the boys JC tennis team. They played at Blackford and won 4-1, leaving their season record to 4-6. Nice job, guys. In J Sports tonight, it's senior night in our boys soccer team, and they'll take on Wapahani. Also, the golf team will travel to Blackford, and the boys tennis team will take on Adams Central. Good luck to our Patriot teams tonight.
He used to play for the Broncos.
The Steelers. After he just recovered from his neck surgery, he has been leading his new team to success. It's been a while since he's worn an orange jersey after playing for the Colts for so long, but he's getting ready to head back into the game. Manning had just reached his milestone as he has played 208 games.
Also, in the men's U.S. Open, Andy Murray becomes the first British man to bring back the title, winning the best of five set matches in 76 years. Murray defeated Djokovic for the championship. The Open final last Monday, Murray pulled his way through and fought to the end against his match against Novak. The match lasted 4 hours and 54 minutes of long work, patience, and worthwhile time. It tied for the record for the longest U.S. Open final. Let's send it back to the hosts.
On Wednesday this week, the high school will be having Spirit Night at the football stadium starting at 6:30. You must have a bracelet to go in, and you can get those bracelets during lunch today, tomorrow, and Wednesday. Let's send it to Abdog and Sayrare here.
Thanks, guys. G.I. Joe has been named the favorite childhood toy by visitors of the Children's Museum in Indianapolis.
The 100 toys and their stories that define our childhood exhibit asked children and their guardians to vote for their favorite toys from a list of 100 toys in the museum. The result represented the various ways children have imagined and played throughout the last century.
The museum narrowed down the list of the top 20 toys. After 8 weeks of voting, the plastic soldier was voted number one, followed by silver Transformers, bronze Legos, Barbie, and at number five, the Master. Look at the top 20 on Indy's Children's Museum website. I'm sure voting for Skip It. What about you, Abby?
Well, stuffed Teletubby for sure. Now let's ask the host what they're voting for.
I'm kind of thinking Furby. What about you?
I'm with the Barbies.
I mean, Furby's kind of creepy, but anyways, hurry up and get those homecoming bracelets for $5 at lunch. You can get into the dance and a Spirit Night.
Let's send it over to E.T. with Joshy Poo.
Thanks, guys. In Hollywood news, actress Blake Lively and her Green Lantern co-star have tied the knot. Brian Williams and Blake Lively were married at the same North Carolina location that The Notebook was filmed. In other news, the third season of American reality talent show The Voice continues tonight. It starts at 10:30. Celebrity birthdays today are rapper Ludacris, who is 35, and the Baltimore Ravens free safety Ed Reed, who is 34. All right, let's send it back to Jenna Squared.
Thanks, Joshy Poo. All right, everybody listen up. It's time to vote for the King and Queen for homecoming. Thursday is the last day to get in your vote before school during lunch from 3:15 to 3:30.
Well, another nice day today. Let's find out what our forecast is for tomorrow, Spirit Night.
Thanks. The temperatures rose more than 25 degrees throughout the day. Look for clear skies tonight and another great day Wednesday. Now for the forecast. Today, a high of 80, a low of 52. Wednesday, a high of 84, a low of 58. Thursday, a high of 84, a low of 58. Friday, a high of 81, a low of 57. And Saturday, a high of 77 and a low of 57. Only a slightly chance for any rain through the weekend. Now back to the Jennas.
And happy birthday to Bree Holcroft. But that's all we have. So see you, Jay.
Later.